I'm my own crew. I'm just setting up the camera here. How are you? It's Judd Apatow here to launch our incredible event tonight. This is so exciting. Thank you for coming. You didn't come anywhere. You're just home. You just turned on the computer or the TV, or you found a way to get the computer to play through the TV. You're doing it. You're a part of this. You didn't have to do this. You could have just watched a Nexium documentary or the other Nexium documentary. The Bachelorette's been kind of incredible this year. Epidermolysis bullosa, a terrible disease that we need to destroy. It's a mouthful, that name. Let's just call it EB for the rest of the night. It's a rare disease that has the attention of some of the greatest minds in research and development. Together, they're transforming the way we can find a cure. It's a revolutionary approach. It's a partnership called EBRP. We're all here raising money to help them get this job done. No one wants me to be talking any longer. There's too much good coming. I know nobody came for me. I'm comfortable with that. It hurts me a little bit, but I get it.
This is Eli. This is Mikey. And this is Tilly. They are each curious, creative, and loving. And they are also some of the strongest people you will ever meet. Born with epidermolysis bullosa, or EB, their strength comes from a profound understanding of pain. Until you meet someone with EB, that pain can be hard to understand.
You are the bravest guy I know, bud.
Epidermolysis bullosa affects the body's largest organ, the skin. People with EB are missing vital proteins that bind the skin together. Without these, the skin tears apart, blisters, and shears off, leading to pain, disfigurement, and wounds that may never heal. They call it the butterfly disease because their skin is said to be as fragile as a butterfly's wings. This is the experience of 500,000 people living with EB worldwide. And because of a lowered life expectancy, they are mostly children, just like Eli, Mikey, and Tilly. But this is changing. What started as the mission of three families living with EB has turned into a bold and innovative movement. Over the years, EBRP has partnered with brilliant researchers and doctors, leading to more than 10 times the amount of clinical trials. And now, we are pioneering a new model for how disease can be cured, venture philanthropy. We don't just write checks and hope for the best. We invest in the most promising projects. When that research proves successful, we use the return on investment to fund even more research until a cure is found. And now EBRP is a global endeavor, ensuring that science does not sleep and research happens 24/7. Curing EB is not an if, it is a when. Scientists know EB's genetic target and are studying cutting-edge techniques like gene editing and stem cell technology to develop a cure. Momentum is everything. We can cure this. Every Eli, Mikey, and Tilly out there deserves to grow up and to live, deserves to fly. Help us heal EB.
Help us, Healy B. Simply, that's the mission. And Ed and I are truly honored to have you join our journey. When you care deeply about something, the thought of it fills all the spaces of your day. Whether you're trying to get work done or running around with kids, it's always there. And that's what it was like bringing this show together. How would we express the brilliance and commitment of our research scientists? How would we capture the spirit and the courage of those living with EB? And how would we inspire you to care as deeply as we do so the thought of curing EB also fills the spaces of your day? It was 12 years ago when I first heard the words epidermolysis bullosa. One of my oldest friends, Ryan, and his wife, Heather, were expecting their first child. Mikey was born blonde with big blue eyes, and he was also born with EB. Like many people, I didn't know what that was. But as Ed and I spent time with Mikey and the family, we learned and we knew we had to get involved. Today, EBRP is driven by some of the greatest minds in medicine and research. We have the roadmap, the team, and the passion to defeat EB. The biggest barrier is not science, it's funding. We are literally at the finish line, and like Ed said, momentum is everything. So let's do it for Mikey, and let's do it for Brady and Rowan. Meet them now.
I remember that day Rowan was born. It was the best day of my life.
We had like a little playlist that we had them play in the delivery room, and I think we were like into the third song, which was Sea of Love. And that's when Rowan was brought into the world.
The day Brady was born, I had invited a friend of mine who takes photos to come capture the experience. And Chris, it was going to be his job to tell me whether it was a boy or a girl. And he just looked up at me with this very strong, loving smile and just said, it's a boy.
When she was born, she looked perfectly healthy. She had some small things on her body, like redness under her fingernails and some what looked like blisters almost on the surface of her eyes, but they were very small. And I was assured that they were just like weird newborn things.
I knew by looking at his feet something was very wrong. He had no skin on his feet.
When she started having wounds appearing, it quickly became like basically like a nightmare.
The look on our doctor's face and of those in the room, they were kind of speechless. And because of the situation, he had no skin on his feet, they told me they wanted to take him. And I just remember looking at Chris and saying, I need to hold him. And they handed him to me and let me kiss him and said, you have about 30 seconds and then we need to get him downstairs. I looked at his face and he was in pain. It wasn't a normal newborn. I knew in my heart that there was something deeper that we were gonna find out.
Can I have a hug for my baby, babe?
They said, well, you know, best case scenario is he could have some horrible bacteria or some horrible flesh-eating virus. And we're like, that's the best case scenario?
Or she has something called epidermolysis bullosa. And he said it so quietly, I didn't even know what he had said. And basically just expressed to us how important it was that we don't try to Google it. So when we go to the doctor's office, it's definitely not like other kids. You know, we have to see primary care, her pediatrician, but we also see dermatology, the infectious disease, neurologists, anesthesiologists, basically most any specialist that you can think of we see with Rowan.
You're okay. I'm also a nurse, and so I'm here with him helping guide our nurses that we're training to be his daily caregivers as well. We also have four different therapists on board.
All the way down. Good job.
Being able to get insurance coverage for a child who requires probably between $10,000 and $15,000 a month in bandaging supplies was incredibly difficult when Rowan was born.
A little bit in rough shape. Hold still, please. Hold still, please. And we do bandage changes every few days with full baths, and bandage changes can go 1 to 3 hours or more. So it's, you know, not for the weak of heart. even at age 3, he has the, you know, body of a 70-year-old. It's just, time is of the essence.
Hi.
I'm here.
You're here. Rowan is the sweetest little girl you'll ever meet. She's beautiful the way she is. And not in spite of her EB, but with her EB.
9, 10.
Brady is an amazing kiddo, and he's as happy as he can be.
She loves dinosaurs, she loves unicorns, she's super outgoing and really funny.
You're right.
My greatest hope for her would be that she is able to be happy. I'm very hopeful that we will find some sort of a treatment that's going to help Rowan's daily life and quality of life.
Yeah.
All right, mommy's turn.
If my friend were to come back and take photos of us today, she would not take photos of a family that's sad and in pain all the time. She would take photos of a family who is fighting and who won't stop fighting until we find an end to this disease.
Peace and blessings. My name is Andra Day. This goes out to all those living with EB, living with pain, but living in strength. Please help us heal EB.
Falling harder than I ever fell before. I'm falling fast while hoping I'll land in your arms. 'Cause all my time is spent there longing to belong to you. Dream of circles, perfect eyes within your face. My heart's an open wound that only you'd replace. And though the moon is rising, can't put your picture down. Love can be frightening when you.
Thank y'all. Peace and blessings.
Hello, everyone. You know, I can't help but think about how much those living with EB can teach us. Lessons in humility, grace, and perhaps most of all, bravery. It's now my honor to introduce one of the bravest young men I've ever come across, John Hudson.
What makes a superhero? Is it a person with super strength, super speed, the power to save lives? Or is it simply the extraordinary courage to inspire others, despite your own pain. John Hudson's origin story began 18 years ago in Staten Island. Born with recessive dystrophic EB, he has the equivalent of third-degree burns practically all over his body. If you've ever experienced a burn, you can imagine only the smallest fraction of his pain.
The pain is just... it's horrible.
An avid comic book fan, John Hudson is inspired by the stories of Doctor Strange, Wolverine, and Spider-Man. None of them are perfect, but stories of transformation and redemption give him hope. But only now is John Hudson realizing his own superpowers. Despite rarely leaving his room, he uses his voice to spread awareness and comfort others who may be struggling.
I like that you can take what you have and use it for good. It's my responsibility to, like, help myself and others with EB.
John Hudson doesn't need a cape to touch lives around the world. With the support of his family, he has donated bandages to people fighting EB in Brazil, all the way to Vietnam. So how would John Hudson like his saga to unfold?
I want it to be a day where if there's a child born with EB, they won't have to live with it long enough to experience the things that I've experienced.
He's waiting for that moment in the story where he can annihilate EB. The moment where the gene therapy works and the first child becomes healed, and then the next, until no more EB.
18 years ago when I was born, and there was absolutely nothing going on. To think that now that there's so many people helping, it's incredible.
Now, John, a good buddy of mine, he goes by the name of Iron Man. Well, he once said that heroes are made by the path they choose, not the powers they're graced with. John Hudson, you may not be on the easiest path, but your story and your journey has touched the lives of so many people. You're my friend, and you're a real hero. It's now my pleasure to turn you over to Jimmy Kimmel. I'll see you soon.
John Hudson, you are an amazing young man and a true hero using your voice to heal EB. Like John Hudson, there are extraordinary people all over the world out there every day helping and healing for humanity. They work tirelessly to find a solution, to find an answer, to find a cure. You're about to meet two heroes in the world of EB at Stanford University. Doctors Anthony Oro and Dr. Jean Yu Tang are leading the way with some groundbreaking research. So let's say hi to the doctors now. Hi, doctors.
Hi, Jimmy.
How are you?
Hi, Jimmy. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you doing? And more importantly, what are you guys doing?
Dr. Tang and I are trying our hardest to provide therapies for the kids with epidermolysis bullosa.
We work on clinical trials, testing new drugs, new therapies on patients, and we work in the lab to discover new genes and new cells that can go in patients.
How do you know you're getting closer? How can you tell? What are the signs?
For the first time ever, there are clinical trials. So we're testing new creams, new gene therapy, new proteins. Many of these treatments look like they're helping the wounds and the skin. It's not a cure yet, but there's a ton of research. There's a ton of excitement, and we're really optimistic for the next couple of years.
What is the toughest nut to crack? What is the hardest thing to figure out?
Well, I think the hardest thing is to, because this disease is lacking the protein for the entire body, we can cure parts of it, like on the skin, but also there's blisters on the inside as well. And that is the major challenge, is really to provide a complete cure for the kids.
What is specifically giving you signs of hope that you're getting close?
So the thing that gives me hope is we're starting to do this first on the skin, whether it's using genes to replace and improve the skin cells on the surface. But when we go for cure, it's replacing all the cells on the surface of the body and internally, and one where you need treatment, but it lasts, not short term.
Is your work with EB something that could benefit people with other rare diseases?
Yeah, so these same therapies can be used for those diseases as well, both rare diseases as well as more common diseases that have wound healing problems.
Jimmy, if we were successful, This would be a triumph for science. When I went into science and medicine, I thought, look at patients and kids with a single gene mutation. Can't we fix that? And if we can fix that, then that opens the entire world for lots of different therapies where we can fix genes. That's the holy grail.
I can't even begin to comprehend how you do this. I can barely even fit in my genes. And I thank God that we have people like the two of you working on this. And this is these are the people that we need to support. You need to have every resource available to help save people's lives, help save families, and just make people happy. And I thank you for doing this, doctors.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Well, let's meet some of these hardworking folks around the world, some of the finest minds in science. Remember science, working to find a cure for EB. Thank you, doctors.
Hi, I'm Dr. Ann Lucky from Cincinnati Children's Hospital. As chair of EBRP's Scientific Advisory Board and a longtime EB physician, I lead the review of all research applications to EBRP and recommend promising projects for funding.
Hello, I'm Dr. Andy South from Thomas Jefferson University. My work focuses on technologies to combat squamous cell carcinoma and heal EB.
Hello, I'm Joanna Jacko from King's College London, England, and I use stem cells to fight squamous cell carcinoma to improve the lives of EB patients.
Hello, I'm Dr. Vicky Chen from Tufts Medical Center. I study treatments for ocular disease to heal EB.
Hello, my name is Dr. Jacob Tolar from University of Minnesota. My lab studies cutting edge gene editing to heal EB.
Hello, I'm Mark D'Souza. I work to establish companies that take innovative therapies to heal EB through clinical trials.
I'm Dr. Dimitra Kivitsi from Freiburg, Germany. I research tissue biomarkers to improve wound care and better design of clinical trials to heal EB.
Hi, I'm Dr. Alison Cowan from the University of South Australia, and I'm developing an antibody therapy for the treatment of EB.
Hello, this is Dr. Alain Hovnanian from INSERM in Paris, France. I research optimal delivery of stem cells to heal epidermolysis bullosa.
Together, all of us are working hard to find a cure for EB.
So please support our important work today.
And now it is our great pleasure, get ready, to introduce Adam Levine.
I seem to recognize your face. Haunting familiar years can seem to place it. Can I find a candle of thought to light your name? Lifetimes catching up. I've seen a place, but no one's ever taken me. Hearts and thoughts, they fade away. Hearts and thoughts, they to see. I just wanna scream, hello.
I'm Laura Dern, and when my beloved friend Jill Vedder asked me if I would come and help out, it was an incredible privilege and honor. She and Ed helped me raise my children as we all co-parent together through life as friends and families. And as a parent, I can't imagine anything more heartbreaking and heart-wrenching than watching what families who are dealing with EB go through. We've met some incredible kids, but we've also met some incredible parents, moms and dads who are right there to help their children in every way possible to keep them healthy, safe, and strong. That's what being a parent is. It's not a title, it's an active verb. Changing bandages, cleaning wounds, and just protecting their child any way they can. What it takes is a fighter. And even though most parents will fight for their kids, not every parent is an actual fighter. Lukas Ortiz is a professional boxer who held the interim heavyweight champion title for 2 years. He can punch and counterpunch and go toe-to-toe with anybody. In fact, he's so tough, they call him King Kong. Over the years, he's taken plenty of hits, but the biggest blow he ever received happened outside the ring when his daughter was diagnosed with EB. That's when he realized who he's really fighting for.
I left Cuba when I was 4 years old. I was really sick, and my father wanted to bring me here to get better.
Crecer en Cuba es algo distinto a crecer en este país. Ellos no tienen. Si comes, no viste, y si viste, no comes.
It's my family. It's my life.
Mi hija nació con una necrosis en el dedo. Querían amputarle el dedo a mi hija. Yo le dije a mi esposa que si le amputaban el dedo a mi hija, yo también me lo iba a amputar. Al mes le diagnosticaron que tenía epidermiólisis bullosa.
The rooster, he's fighting.
Yeah, he's right. A fighter. I have very sensitive skin, and if I get scratched, it just opens. I barely hurt anymore. I feel a lot better, and I don't get sick very often.
Gracias a Dios, ella está bien. Hay cosas que no puede hacer. Hay días que ella no está bien y se llena de ampolla y eso hay que tener fuerza para curarla porque eso le duele demasiado. Mis hijos son todo para mí. Ellos son la razón por la que yo me subo al ring y entreno todos los días. Ellos son mi razón de triunfar.
Bonsoir, mes amis. From a small farmhouse in the middle of France, good evening. I sing this song in memory of a wonderful evening spent in California overlooking the hillsides and singing in a garden, drinking cups of tea around good friends and raising money for the EB Research Foundation among dear friends. But I'm stuck here and we're all stuck here and we gotta find the music where it is and we gotta send it from where we are. So this is a song called The Song of Good Hope and I send it to anybody who needs it. We're gonna make it across this river alive. You need to think like a bull and go with the tide. And I know where you've been has really left you in doubt. Ever find in a harbor or figuring this out, then you're gonna need all the help you can get. So lift up your arms now and reach for it. Reach for it. And take your time, babe. It's not as bad as it seems. You'll be fine, babe. It's just some rivers and streams in between where you are and wanna be. Watch the signs now, you'll know what they mean. You'll be fine now, just stay close to me and make good hope walk with you through everything. Da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. Take your time, babe. It's not as bad as it seems. You'll be fine, babe. It's just some rivers and streams in between where you are and wanna be. And watch the signs now, you'll know what they mean. You'll be fine now, just stay close to me and make good hope walk with you through everything. May this song of good hope walk with you through everything. Hopefully we'll see you next year. Thank you.
Hey everyone. So I know that this night has been all about learning and rallying together so we can help to cure EB. But right now, just for a minute, I wanted to talk to those of you out there who have EB, who live with EB every day. I know your days can be hard. I know sometimes you feel different, but actually different is okay. Different is great. So embrace it and love you for you. The first instrument I learned was the ukulele. It helped me find my voice, so I wanted to give this custom Fender uke to EBRP, with all proceeds helping to find a cure. Now's the time. Let's heal EB.
Hi all, Gaten here to talk rare disease. Sometimes so rare, people don't even know what they are. I know because I have one. It's called cleidocranial dysplasia. I was born with it. It affects the way that I look, my bones and my teeth. And whether it's CCD or EB, having a rare disease does make us different. But different is what keeps things interesting. Accepting our differences isn't always easy, especially when we're fed perfect on the regular. But there's no such thing. So we need to flip the script on how we look at ourselves. And that's exactly what Olivia Vedder and Lucy Beale are all about. They're super cool, super awesome, so please check them out and listen up.
We are all beautiful, whether you have a visible condition like EB, something no one else can see, or any other perfect imperfections.
Beauty is not rare. In fact, beauty is everywhere. I'm Olivia Vedder, and together with my friend Lucy Bell, we are flipping the script on the beauty standard.
Growing up, I didn't see myself reflected in any form of media.
I thought there was something wrong with my body. I thought that I should be ashamed or embarrassed. The truth is, the problem was on TV, in magazines, and all over social media. So now is the time to challenge the landscape and prove that beauty lives in each of us. Our goal is to turn social media into a positive space and validate the fact that beauty is not rare. So when we asked people to post photos that made them feel beautiful, they answered with pride, inspiration, and positivity. Like Ariana, who taught us that to be rare is to be special and cherished. Deanna and her fearless quote, "Some women fear the fire and others simply become the flame." And Sharday, who is living her life loud and to the fullest.
On our journey to heal EB, let's also work on healing our own feelings of self-worth and self-love.
Go share your story with the hashtag Beauty is not rare.
Olivia and Lucy, you're right. Beauty is not rare. And I want to thank you guys so much for flipping the script on beauty standards. That's actually what inspired this next song, Self-Love and Self-Acceptance. And it's called Scars to Your Beautiful. So hope you enjoy.
She just wants to be beautiful. She goes unnoticed. She knows no limits. She craves attention. She praises an image. She prays to be sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see the light that's shining deeper than the eyes can find it. Maybe we have made her blind, so she tries to cover up her pain and cut her woes away. 'Cause cover girls don't cry after the face is made. But there's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars till you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful. Oh, 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 oh. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars till you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful. Now she has dreams to be an envy, so she's starving, you know. Cover girls eat nothing. She says beauty is pain and there's beauty in everything. What's a little bit of hunger? I can go a little while longer. She fades away. She don't see her perfect. She don't understand. She's worth it. All that beauty goes deeper than the surface. Oh, oh, oh. So to everyone who's hurting, let me see a little bit clearer. The light that shines within, there's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars till you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful. You shine up a star. Oh, you're beautiful. Oh, you're beautiful. There's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars till you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful. Stars and we're beautiful.
Thank you so much to all of you beautiful people for watching, and together let's heal EB.
Hi, my name is Greg Lemkaw, and my wife Kate and I are honored to support EB Research Partnership and its mission to cure EB. When we first learned about this genetic disorder and saw the challenges faced by those families impacted by it, we felt compelled to help. We are fortunate. EB doesn't impact our family directly, but that's precisely why we decided to help, because we believe strongly that it can't just be families impacted by EB that help find a cure. It's going to take all of us. As parents of four kids, Kate and I know how important it is to be able to help our children, and we want all the children living with EB to know that we're there for them as well. We're inspired that our support can provide life-saving healing for families that battle EB every day, and in the process, lead a research model that can help deliver cures for thousands of other diseases affecting millions of people. So please, consider joining us, as together, we can be part of the team that will cure EB in our lifetime. I'd like to close by giving special thanks to Jill and Eddie Vedder and to the Silver family for their leadership in finding the way to a cure. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the evening.
The day Jackson was born, I had a really normal delivery, and he came out this beautiful 9-pound boy, but quickly they put a Band-Aid on his foot. I had gestational diabetes, and when they took the Band-Aid off, it took all the skin off his entire foot, and he was rushed to the NICU.
Jamie took every precaution through her pregnancy, and to come into the world and experience such pain so quickly was... it was devastating.
At the time where Jackson was born, other than a Yahoo chat group, there was really nowhere to go as a great resource. And there certainly was nowhere to go as a resource for what is happening in the world of research.
We looked around and didn't see an organization doing what we wanted to accomplish, which was very simple. We want to advance research as quickly as possible to lead to sustainably commercial solutions to treat and cure EB for all children and adults.
And so what was our alternative other than to jump in and say, we're gonna do something. We're gonna try to help our child. We're gonna try to help everyone who's suffering from this.
It's almost like a jigsaw puzzle, but every piece is white and you have no pattern to put it into. But you know, at some point, it's gonna form a rectangle. But until then, you're just picking up piece by piece and laying it on the ground with the belief and faith and hope that somehow you're gonna get all these pieces together. The difference between then and today is the state of research, which has been advanced by EB Research Partnership, has dramatically changed the potential for treatments and functional cures, and ultimately a true cure, in a way that wasn't available 13 years ago at all. And if you look where we are now, there are more phase one, phase two, and now phase three trials than there ever have been in the history of research. We are not there yet. We are much farther along than we were. And I can tell any parent and look him or her in the eyes, or, you know, and hold his hand or her hand and say, we realistically, realistically have the ability to treat and cure this for the generation that's living with it today. If, and only if, we have the resources to get us all the way there.
Hello, everybody. It's Adam Sandler and my beard. How about the kids? They're unbelievable. They're very inspirational. You know that. You watch these kids and you're like, you know what? I suck. I'm an awful, awful thing. But I want to introduce you to a kid that is awesome. I got to know him. Aaron Owens is the kid. He's 16 years old. He's got EB. He's faced a lot of challenges living with the disease, but he's done it with humor and just being funny, and he's got wit, and he's got it all, man. He's cool.
Yo, you're a legend, bro. Yo, thank you so much, man. Guys, we're hopping into a game right now.
He's a big-time gamer also. He's so good that people from all over watch him play live. In the gaming community, he's known as That Geek Aaron. People love this kid so much, they watch a dude who calls himself a geek play video games. He's that cool. And on top of that, when he's not putting on a show playing video games, he wants to use his platform to raise awareness around EB.
Bro, you inspire me so much. Thank you so much, Rocky. I appreciate that, bro.
He's a great man and a great kid, and I'm gonna talk to him. Aaron, are you there?
Yo.
Aaron? Dude.
Yo, what's up?
Man, what's up? You look cool, brother. I'm so happy to see you, man.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah, we have fun. You're cool. And what room are you in right now? I like that room.
Oh, I'm in my bedroom, bro.
This is the bed. So this is where it all goes down. This is where you beat people at video games and laugh in their face.
Yeah.
When you do win and you give somebody a whooping, what's your first, like, do you have a signature move, like, you just got Aaron'd, or what do you say?
It's what all these gamers say, but like you just got smacked, or you just got rolled. We're all just like dance on them, you know, those Fortnite dances.
Can I show you what my kid showed me one time and tell me what the hell I'm doing here? So my kid does this. Goes like this. This weird thing. What the hell is that?
Yeah.
What?
I think it's called like the Orange Justice.
Yeah, what the hell is that? What game is that from, and can we make it go away? I don't like doing it.
Yeah, it's from Fortnite.
Yeah, yeah. And what you love.
Yeah.
When I first met you, you showed me a picture of Pop, and I said, that man looks like he can throw down if he needs to. Am I right?
Yeah, can I bring him in?
Bring on Pops, I want to see him.
Yo!
Daddy!
Oh,
what's up, buddy? I'm happy you're here, man.
How are you?
Good to see you, buddy. Your son is so damn cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'm very proud of him.
I know,
you
man.
Know?
I know. You two are the tightest together. It's the best, man, that he loves you so much. So you just want to all day long, as much as you can, raise awareness and raise money for EB.
Well, I want to spread as much awareness for EB as I can. So if you saw, or you'd go to my Twitch channel, Zachy Garen, you'd see that I have a bio which explains my condition, and I have multiple cameras, one showing my hand cam, which has been, or showing my hands that have been affected by EB, and also I have a foot cam, which shows my skills in action and advantages that provide lifelong protection until we cure this disease.
Yeah, man.
Oh, that's great. I think that's amazing, buddy. I love that. You are just cool as hell, buddy. You just make everything, you make my life better, buddy, that I know you. And you keep doing what you're doing for everybody with EB and yourself, and we love you, buddy.
All right. Yo, you wanna fist bump the camera?
Let's go. Respect.
Hello, my friend, it's been a while. All our old clothes are back in style. We went our separate ways, only to return to face a lesson we failed to learn. And we didn't understand the truth. We were blinded by the eyes of you. But time kept on moving, and the changes come. And you think that I don't know where you're coming from. Well, I feel just like you, and I cry just like you. But I heal just like you, and under my skin I'm just like you. And you gave your love and your innocence, and they took away your confidence. You're not those women, and I'm not those men. Put your arms around me, I am your friend. And I feel just like you, and I cry just like you. But I heal just like you. Oh, and under my skin I'm just like you and everybody else. When I get hurt, I cry for help. And I've got secrets God only knows. And God knows I feel just like you, and I cry just like you. But I heal just like you, and I break down just like you. Well, I feel just like you, oh, and I cry just like you. But I'm weak just like you, and under my skin I'm just like you.
My name is Eli Meyer. I am 6 years old. I'm just a regular kid, but I have epidermolysis bullosa. You can call it EB. It's easier. EB is a rare condition. Sometimes it hurts.
Eli was adopted from China when he was 4 years old.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Oh,
Our family knew he had EB, but that didn't make a difference. Eli is a superhero to me. It makes me sad when people stare or point at him, and sometimes they can say things that are really hurtful.
I tell people I was born different, but we are all born different, and that's great. We can all learn from each other.
We want people to know if someone looks different than you, instead of staring, they should come say hi.
Hi!
I hope that when people see our shirts, they'll take a minute to stop and learn more about Eli and EB. I think if we all come say hi, we can do a lot of good things together.
I want to teach you about EB.
EB?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You guys
welcome.
Have a wonderful day.
You too.
The more we understand each other, the better the world will be. Some people say my skin is like the wings of the butterfly because it can break easily. Butterfly wings are fragile, but they also help them fly. I may have EB, but I'm going to keep on trying.
I'll come and say hi when I see Eli. I'll come and say hi. I'll come and say hi when I see Eli. I'll come and say hi. Oh, Eli, you're a thief. You stole my heart. As I dream, I see your wings glow in the dark. Oh, message that rings loud and true, indelible, coming from you. Oh, you make the connection, and I'll follow your suggestion when you say, I'll come and say hi. When I see Eli, I'll come and say hi. I'll come and say hi. When I see Eli, I'll come and say hi. Oh, Eli, your wisdom belies your age. Oh, here's to you, a guru of strength and grace. Cause the first one to reach out a hand shows more courage than the one who does less. With all our imperfections, your light shines in all directions, cutting through. I'll come and say hi when I see Eli. I'll come and say hi. I'll come and say hi when I see Eli. I'll come and say hi. Oh, I'll come and say hi when I see Eli. I'll come and say hi. Oh, I'll come and say hi when I see Eli. I'll come and say hi. Oh, Eli, I'll come and say hi.
We all know how difficult it is to truly understand someone unless we have the opportunity to live their experiences. So to better understand what it's like to raise a child with EB, we asked one mother to share her experiences with us. Accompanied by the incomparable Jon Batiste, I'm honored to share her story. You ready, John?
I'm ready, Renée.
My son, Salim, is the light of my life. Salim spent the first 3.5 years of his life in an orphanage in India, but in March 2018, I completed his adoption process and was able to bring my little boy home to North Carolina. At the time, I knew he'd been born with EB, but what I didn't understand was how my world was about to change. Salim has recessive dystrophic EB. It ravages not only the skin we can see, but his insides as well. How can I possibly describe a day in our life? It's filled with bandage changes, tube feeds, ordering supplies, countless medications, and fighting for services. But that's not all. It's also filled with Salim's laughter, beautiful sense of wonder, and endless love. I adopted my son knowing that I will likely outlive him. So we savor each moment a little more, knowing that it is truly a gift. The reward of watching him work through the toughest of days fills my heart. Thanks to Salim, I know more, I see more, and I love more than I ever knew I could. And I will keep on loving him with the fiercest, deepest, most unrelenting love in the world for every single moment I have him. Laura and Salim, thank you for sharing your story. The way you live every day and love every day helps us learn and understand a little bit more. So let's do what we can to find a cure for EB. If you haven't already, please donate. Let's heal EB.
Thank you for joining us on our mission to rapidly accelerate life-saving treatments and cures for EB. We have one bold, audacious goal: cure EB and cure it quickly. The biggest obstacle to curing EB isn't science, it's funding. Now is a transformational moment in time. We know our targets, we have it in our sights. There are researchers across the globe leveraging cutting-edge technology like gene editing and exon skipping to solve our problem. It's up to us to accelerate research from the bench in a lab to the bedside of a patient at the speed of light. For those living with EB, time is a valuable asset. What we have before us is a uniquely solvable problem. With your help, curing EB is not an if, it's only a when. There will be more clinical trials for EB in the next 3 years than in the last 10 years combined. With all of our progress, we still face an urgent problem. Today, there are currently no approved treatments for EB, but we are changing that as rapidly as possible. When we accomplish this with your help, what does our future look like? It means that a schedule once filled with doctors' visits and bleach baths and appointments from all kinds of medical professionals can be filled with vacations and new adventures. It means no more fear. It means no more pain. It means a cure. On behalf of the entire EB community, it's our honor to have you fighting with us, and we thank you for helping us to heal EB.
So here we are. We've met the families, heard from the doctors, and learned about EBRP's innovative business model. Let's be clear. We know this is a rare disease with a rare opportunity, and a cure is actually within reach. That's big. But what's happening here is even bigger than EB. If we find a cure for EB today, we can help cure 7,000 other rare diseases tomorrow. That's 400 million people, 10% of the global population, 95% of which do not have any treatments. The extraordinary research underway stretches beyond this one disease. By fixing a single mutation in one gene, we can change lives all over the world. We know that EB has a team fighting to find a cure, and we've met many of them tonight. Now it's my pleasure to introduce another member of the team to heal EB, my friend Lukas Nelson and Promise of the Real, featuring his brother Micah and their father, the legend Willie Nelson.
Coming back.
back here. I'm gonna stay until my bones have turned to leaves. I'm waiting on a word, hanging on a prayer. White walls, lightning bolt, keep my feet on the ground. And if I lose my babe, I'll tell you where they can lay. Set me down on a cloud with my soul turned inside out. Well, they fixed me up good, but my heart still bleeds. There's only one thing in this world to let me heal. Baby, open up your eyes and tell me you're not leaving. And I'm gonna make you feel so good it won't feel real. I'm waiting on a word. If I lose my babe, I'll tell you where they can lay me. Set me down on a cloud with my soul turned inside out. Set me down on a cloud with my soul turned inside out.
Hi, my name is Dave Letterman, and perhaps you know me as Dave. For 33 years, I hosted a talk show, and we had the great pleasure of experiencing music on that show every single night. Some of the finest performers in the business. And some came and went, and some made a lasting impression on me. And I'm talking about one particular group, Pearl Jam. They were on the show multiple times, and every time they were on the show, they blew the roof off the dump. And I'm not speaking figuratively here. We actually had to repair, oh my God, the bills. They're a band that believes in fighting for big things, things that matter, giving a voice to the voiceless and recognizing injustice by standing up for what is right. That's Pearl Jam. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is my friend Eddie Vedder. So it comes to no surprise that he and his wife, Jill, are pouring their heart and soul into EB Research Partnership and venturing to find a cure for the disease. For the young people, families, and all those living with and working to cure EB, Ed has written a brand new song. Now this song is brought to life, adding another dimension, by the brilliant illustrator Jeff Lemire. So ladies and gentlemen, it's my great honor, thrill, and privilege to introduce the world premiere of Matter of Time.
Bandage up all our parts. Well, I'm a builder of
bridges and I could fly us up to the moon. When your time is limited, well, nothing happens too soon. Navigate, come find a way. Our differences be damned. So much space between us and the distance of our hands. Stakes are raised to elevate, just a second to understand. What you give, this will to live. You got the cure, I'll fight the fight. It's just a matter of time. Take the stand and let the truth testify. If I were but a grain of sand, I'd still resist this tide. But we're not alone on this crowded shore, and times they do demand strength of space between us, a reaching of a hand. Stakes are raised to elevate, second to understand. What you give, this will to live. You got the cure, I got the fight. It's just a matter of time. A matter of time. Just a matter of time.
Just a matter of time, but time is of the essence. So please do what you can to join this global community, and let's give these kids the wings to fly.
Thank you.